Hello everyone, thank you for taking time and watching this video. I would like to talk to you about this upcoming City of Fort Worth project. My name is Shweta Rao and I am one of the project managers in Transportation and Public Works Department's Capital Delivery Team. And I'll be the construction project manager for the upcoming Colonial Parkway Sidewalk project. This presentation was originally meant to be given at an in-person community meeting with all affected residents and other citizens who would utilize this location. However, due to city's proactive response to the current coronavirus outbreak, the meeting has been canceled and this presentation has been recorded in lieu of actual meeting. This presentation is meant to provide you with some information about the scope of this project and what is happening in your neighborhood, and also provide you on details of the project and the schedule for construction. The design engineering firm on this project is Dunaway Associates. The limits of this project are on Colonial Parkway from Country Club Drive to Rogers Road. Here is the agenda of what I hope to cover in my brief presentation. I'll be talking about the project as a whole, reviewing the scope of the project, some of the design considerations and schedule for construction. The limits of this project include Colonial Parkway from Country Club Drive to Rogers Road and on Rogers Road from Colonial Parkway to Trinity River Bridge. The proposed sidewalk will be installed on north side of Colonial Parkway and continuing to the west side of Rogers Road. This project will improve walkability by providing safe path for pedestrians to walk along the Colonial Parkway. It will provide a safer connectivity to the Colonial Country Club. The project includes 2,500 linear feet of sidewalk and we will be reconstructing the driveway for Colonial Country Club to meet the ADA standards. The project is funded by 2018 Bond Sidewalk Fund and is one of the 5 locations included under our Year 2 list for sidewalks. The construction cost estimate for this project is around $330,000. This slide shows the proposed location for sidewalks along Colonial Country Club. As we can see that the available parkway at this location is very limited. The sidewalk is designed to be back of curb for most of the part. But to achieve the ADA requirement of at least 4 feet, there might be a need to trim shrubs a bit. To maintain the aesthetics of the area, we are not recommending removal of any shrubs. They just need to be trimmed a bit to provide proper walkable surface to the pedestrians. As we can see in this picture, the right-of-way is very limited and has old mature trees very close to each other. The proposed design does not anticipate any removal of trees. To save the tree roots to ensure the health of these trees, cast iron grates have been proposed. The grates will provide safety to the tree roots and reduce the impact of construction around it. This picture also shows the grade drop towards the golf course. The current grade at this location leads all the stormwater to flow towards the golf course instead of the roadway. To allow the stormwater to flow towards the roadway, a retaining wall with pedestrian railing back of sidewalk is proposed at this location. The picture in the slide shows how the sidewalk with pedestrian railing will look like. The sidewalk will be built to ADA standards to make it accessible for everyone. They will generally be 5 feet wide with a narrowed sections around the trees. The cross slope will be maintained to 2%. The Colonial Country Club entrance driveway will also be reconstructed to meet ADA requirements of 5 feet sidewalk and 2% cross slope. The proposed railing is a TxDOT standard rail and will provide safety to pedestrians along the retaining wall sections. This project also includes some pavement marking modification at intersection of Rogers Road and Colonial Parkway. While our team was out on site to inspect the location, we found that cars are merging at a high speed while coming from Rogers Road to the Colonial Parkway. And the reason for this is the lack of proper pavement marking to align the traffic flow to merge properly. So to improve the safety of merging traffic from Rogers Road to Colonial Parkway, pavement markings will be installed around the splitter islands. This will help the traffic to merge into proper lanes. Also, the new pavement marking will reduce the speed at the intersection, which will increase safety for pedestrians walking along the corridor. Coming to the project schedule, we are currently at preliminary design phase, which means we are at 60% design for this project. We are anticipating start of construction by late summer 2020. We do not anticipate any changes to the schedule at this point. And the duration of the construction would be around 4 months. I would like to finish the presentation by presenting some frequently asked questions regarding this project and providing answers. So the first one is, will there be any roadway closures during construction? We do not anticipate any roadway closures for construction, but there will be parts of roadway blocked for storing the construction material and machinery, but it will not be impacting the movement of traffic in the neighborhood. Why is a new traffic pattern or pavement markings being installed? The new traffic pattern or pavement marking will improve the flow and direct the traffic into correct lane for travel. This will also increase safety for pedestrians by slowing down the speeds of merging traffic. Do we have minimum sidewalk ADA width in this location where trees are located? The usual ADA requirement for sidewalk is a minimum of 4 feet walkable surface. The only location that we will have width less than that is when we are traversing around the trees. The width of that section will be around 3.5 feet to 4 feet. The width was reduced to keep the trees intact and avoid tree removals. Coming to the next question, are we impacting driveways in this project? If so, will there be any access to the property during driveway construction? There will be only one driveway reconstruction in this project, and it is the entry to the golf course. We will be replacing one panel at a time to provide continuous access to the property at all times. In this location, will the water drain towards the golf course with the proposed sidewalk? The proposed design of sidewalk will allow the water to drain towards the roadway instead of the golf course. Retaining walls have been provided where there is a great difference between the curb and back of sidewalk. The next question is, will the construction materials be left on road during construction? The contractor has to clean the work site every day before they leave. So the contractor might leave the materials and machinery on site but will clean the dirt before leaving. Thank you very much for taking time to listen and watch this video. It is unfortunate that I was not able to meet you all in person due to public health concerns and also discuss any comments or questions that you may have. But I would still like to hear from you. My phone number and email address are provided here. Please feel free to contact me if you choose. Thank you all again.